Hey everybody, it's Tuesday and I promised you I'd do pre-recorded videos and here I am doing it. This is Tuesday, January 23rd. I should check the calendar more frequently. I am just tuning in to what's going on. So tempted to go to New Hampshire. I'll be there energetically. It's not very far away, but we're gonna have our Grassroots of Democracy guided meditation for a healed America. It's Tuesday. Just know that we do that every single week. There's a lot brewing and I know that this week is gonna be pretty huge. So stay on top of the news and pay attention to what's going on. There are nefarious forces underneath and behind the scenes that are trying to rig things. So I don't think that's gonna interfere in New Hampshire. This is more the nefarious forces. And it's not that they're not being countered, because they are. Like the loser team has a very clear idea. I don't want to say clean idea. Very clear idea of what they want to do to the United States of America. And I want to tell you, at the same time, I feel like Americans are starting to get the message that this is dangerous. And let me say something about the northeast part of the country where I live. People here tend to be educated. And I don't mean to, you know, I love the uneducated, right? It's not a judgment. But this is where, you know, like parts of the country where people come, this is where Harvard is, right? This is where the part of the country where you'll find people in more deep discussions, more literate, more aware of current events, more thoughtful, and this is at the risk of sounding judgmental. I'm just saying the way that it is, the way that it is. The MAG has pointed this part of the country and they think we're all the coastal elites, right? There's nothing wrong with having a healthy curiosity and a healthy intellect and an education. And I'm picking up that the people in New Hampshire are starting to wake up. I have seen a couple of clips of people in New Hampshire that when they're being asked what they think, if they'd ever vote for the loser again, my words, the loser, they've thought about it. And they've thought about what happened on January 6th. And even though they voted for the loser in the past, they have vowed they would not vote for him again. And I heard one woman talking about, she thinks about her children and her grandchildren. I think about my nieces and nephews. I think about my family. I think about the people that don't seem to be paying attention to what's going on, even though they're not MAGA. You know, not paying attention to what would happen to them. So I'm stepping it up and getting people to pay more and more attention. And as you all know, I want to take a look at what's going to happen in New Hampshire. Now I'm going to take a risk and check the pendulum, being fully aware that the pendulum measures the energy of a situation. So I'm just going to ask, will Nikki Haley win in New Hampshire? Will Nikki Haley win in New Hampshire? I've already checked earlier and I've gotten yes 3 times already. So this is the 4th time I'm getting a yes on Nikki Haley winning New Hampshire. I know it's hard to believe, but we've got to start having our thoughts go there. I mean, I'm not saying I want Nikki Haley to be president. We just want less winning for the loser, because he's a loser and losers are called losers because they don't win. And 2016 was Russia. I do want to speak to sometimes I see a comment or I hear a comment here and there about November. And I've heard people saying, this is my opinion. I've heard people saying, astrologically, and we'll talk to Kathy Beale about this too. Oh, astrologically, it's going to be a you-know-what show. I don't adhere to that kind of speaking. That's not factual. If there are challenging aspects in November for the election, so be it. There were also challenging aspects in 2022 and 2023, and we got through it. There were also challenging aspects in 2020, and we got through January 6, 2021. We have to count our blessings. So I'm not of the ilk that, oh, it's going to be terrible. I think those of you that come here on a regular basis and are members or just viewers, you know that about me. I was building a pretty good viewership and subscribership when Putin invaded Ukraine. And I needed to step back, and I lost a lot of viewers. I had to build back up from scratch. The reason that I stepped back was because I really got a message from the guides that I wasn't to interfere with the way that people would think about the war. And I think that was really because I would have picked up that it was going to drone on and it was going to be awful. That's just me. That's how I operate. It's not good, bad, or it's just that it's important that we recognize that how we think changes trajectories. And if we're thinking, oh no, all gloom and doom, guess what? We're heading in that direction. So that's why every Tuesday night we have 20 on Tuesdays, a guided meditation for a healed America. We get our thoughts going in the right direction. If you happen to be watching this on a Tuesday and you're not signed up, go to grassrootsofdemocracy.com and put your email address in for 20 on Tuesdays, and you'll get the Zoom invite. I'm going to make these videos as short as I can and just answer a couple of questions. So the two questions I have right now, maybe three. It's hard to cut these things short. I'm going to do my best. Maybe three. The outcome in New Hampshire. I felt all along that Haley has more momentum than we're really able to see on the surface. And it's completely propelled by hatred for the loser. People are getting scared. People that are paying attention are getting scared. And we actually need more of that. We need more people that are afraid and that will mobilize because of it. That will do everything in our power. Nikki Haley in New Hampshire. Okay, so I have the death card and the devil card. There's going to be a disruption. I had a vision of the loser in front of a crowd. I was just kind of walking and I saw this vision of the loser in front of the crowd at a rally. And in my vision, I don't know what this was, but in my vision, I saw him saying, I hate you, to the crowd. And that was interesting. That was my vision I saw in my third eye. And I think what that was I was picking up how he really feels about the people at these rallies. I was just picking up, I hate you, I hate you. I think that's kind of accurate. He just wants to use people for what he can get out of them. This is so interesting because I have the devil and the death card. And I just mentioned that there were nefarious forces behind the scenes. The Four of Rods. Well, there's a big ending here, which makes sense. And I have the devil. It's a little disconcerting how often I get the devil when I read on the loser. I'm going to pull a couple of clarifiers because I want to see if this means the end of Nikki Haley. Not getting that's the end for her. And the devil card is the deception and the lies of the loser. The Four of Rods is actually, that's not a bad card for Nikki Haley. I think she stays in. I think she stays in. I'm kind of seeing a little bit of a dead heat. I'm seeing the loser being a little bit like shaken and incredulous. And it may be just because her numbers are way higher than anybody expected. The pendulum reads energy and it says the loser is not going to win. All right. Next thing to read on is, I'd like to read on, I've been avoiding this, but last night I told everyone, I think it was last night, to please pray for the border. I'm still, and please pray that people get the truth about the border, because they're thinking, intelligent people out there, like I've heard some of them on the news, that are blaming Biden for the border. That has to stop. Just tell everyone, that needs to stop. That it's not his fault. He really didn't do anything to create the crisis at the border. That's all propaganda. Quite to the contrary. They keep presenting the Republicans, I'll just call them that for a second. The administration keeps presenting them. How about this? How about that? We're working on it. You know, we got to figure this out. And they keep saying, no, if Biden had anything to do with it, we're going to say no. So now our national security is at risk. Because the Ukraine money is in the package. So I'm talking all about that, and I really need to focus more on the question. I'm going to ask about the border. The federal government moved in and said, remove the razor wire. Hello, already, Mr. King sociopath Abbott. So I'm pulling three cards about what we can expect over the next few days. I keep getting amnesty. Whenever I think about the border, I keep getting amnesty. Death card again. There will be more deaths. That's interesting. I'm getting the death card again. The lover card. And the three. What I'm seeing is there will be more deaths, and this is going to get a little bit heated up. And the lover card is indicating that the humanity is going to come through. The humanitarians are going to come through. But this looks like there will be more deaths at the border, and they're going to be public. People will know. And the lover card is indicative of people that in America that don't want to be viewed as the cruel country. I actually see that there's something going on with the situation at the border. It's almost like what Abbott is doing backfires. It reminds me of when the loser shut the government down, and it was around the holidays in 2019, I think it was. I think it was 2018 or 2019, and people came together and helped one another, even though he was inflicting all this pain unnecessarily. I do see people, this is actually making people more aware of the suffering that Abbott is inflicting at the border. So there will be a change, but I see more deaths at the border. And then people just saying, whoa, this is, we need to stop this. We need to rally. This is terrible. So that's what we can expect to see this week, some of that. Abbott is, talk about a dereliction of duty. This is completely treasonous. Completely treasonous. He can't just take Texas out of the United States. I mean, and that's basically what he's doing. So let's ask the pendulum. Is King Abbott going to be held, is he going to be prosecuted? Will he be prosecuted? Yes. Yes, he's basically indirectly murdering these people. Yes, he will be prosecuted for this. He's going to be connected to the crime of murder. Somebody told me that his wife is Mexican, and I just, whenever I think about that, I don't know. I don't really know his life. I'm not really interested in Greg Abbott's life, but if his wife is Mexican and he's treating Mexicans the way that he is, they're not just Mexicans, I know that, but my first thought whenever I think about that is her role must look much like a servant, just based on how he is. I mean, the man's not capable of love, as we can see. He's a total sociopath. One last thing. I'm going to look at how the week's going to go with these elections. And then I'll be seeing you tonight if you come to the 20 on Tuesdays guided meditation for Healed America. You receive the recording afterwards if you're signed up. How this election week is going to go. We will feel a bit more burdened. It looks like Haley's still in the race. It looks like the loser and Haley's still in the race. It's gonna make us feel more burdened in a particular kind of a way. And we already feel that. Like I was saying last night, it's only the third week in January, and I'm so sick of hearing about the election, and we've got 10 months to go. Yikes! Let me leave you with three cards for to get you through till tomorrow, till Wednesday. And Wednesday night we have our, as per usual, PNN Psychic News Network live. So for the next couple of days, no, the magician is telling you anything can change at any minute. Remember that. We're in this really powerful Aquarian energy right now. Sun in Aquarius, Pluto just moved into Aquarius. Just know that anything can just turn on a dime. And the Knight of Cups, there is, we're going to see the Knight of Cups and the Page of Swords. I see, and I've been seeing this, more legal action taken, but it's not just against the loser. MAGA Mike comes to mind. All right, that's what I have for now. Before I go, I just want to let everyone know, remind you that it's psychicannettedion.com to book a reading. I'm doing a special until through February 12th. Book a reading that will get your energy up from the winter doldrums. It's basically an energy reading. I read your energy. That's on the phone. That's on the website, psychicannettedion.com. So if you're feeling low energy and you need some help, I'll read your energy. It's not a medical evaluation. It's simply, I offer you suggestions based on what your guides say as to how you can, you know, feel more energetic in the winter months. So that's through February 12th. Book your session now. GrassrootsOfDemocracy.com is where you go to sign up to help save democracy. And I think the moose is going to be called Midas, the moose, the democracy moose, because that the sound of that word will go a long way, that name. And what else? That's all for now. So I'll see you again soon. When you become a member, however, you get a free affirmation in your inbox every day. All right. Wow, I did it. I did a short video. Thank you, and we'll see you soon. Namaste. Keep the faith. Bye.